Assalamualaikum, I hope you all are fine. Welcome back to MLS Online Virtual Classroom. My dear students, we are going to start our chapter number 2. The title of the chapter is the Ghaznavid, and it is regarding the first empire which was being established in subcontinent. Now today's target is to take an overview of Ghaznavid rule, and then we would be doing the new words. So basically, in the Ghaznavid rule, there are different kings who ruled over this area of subcontinent. They all were Muslims. But one of the famous of those kings is Mahmud Ghaznavi. You might have heard about him as well. Mahmud Ghaznavi is famous for his 17 attacks on India. And he also broke the idols, or you can say destroyed the idols of the temple known as Somnath. You might have heard in Urdu like that, Somnath ke Bud. So he destroyed those temples and their idols. And along with Mahmud Ghaznavi, there are certain other rulers of this area as well, just as Alptekin, Sabuttekin, who were basically slaves, while Mahmud Ghaznavi was the ruler, who was an independent person who became the ruler, while others were slaves. Let's move forward and see the new words for this lecture. In the upcoming lecture, we would be discussing the Ghaznavid dynasty in detail. So we have to learn these new words and their meaning as well. The first one is Alptekin. And Alptekin was a Turk's slave commander. Slave means hulam, and commander is a post in army. So who was Alptekin? Alptekin was a Turk's slave commander. I hope the meaning is clear. The next word we have, succeeded. Now succeeded means achieve the desired aim or result. Something that you have in your mind that you would achieve that. Either it can be any goal in any sphere, either educational, social or financial. And after achieving that goal, you would be known as succeeded. Okay. And you might also know about this meaning in terms of mathematics, where you use the word successor and predecessor. The word which comes after a word, the number which comes after another number is known as the successor number. In the same manner, something that is being achieved, which you had in your mind regarding any goal or aim, that by achieving that goal, you become succeeded. As you can see in the picture as well, that the person has achieved his trophy and his goal, so they are winner and have achieved their success. The next word is Sabuktagin. Now, who is Sabuktagin? He was the founder of the Ghaznavid dynasty. The Ghaznavid rule in subcontinent was being established by Sabuktagin. He was the first one, or you can say he was the first ruler who laid the foundation of Ghaznavid dynasty. In the chapter, we would be discussing his rule in detail. Let's move forward. The next word is competent. Competent, and it means having the necessary ability to do something. For example, we know about the word competition. In competition, we compete. Compete means that we and other fellows, we compete against each other or together. So competent basically means having the necessary ability to do something, to compete. For example, I say that I'm competent enough to win this race. I mean to say that I have the ability which is required to win this race, and I possess this ability. So I call myself competent enough to win this race. So ultimately, competent means having the necessary ability to do something. Okay, the next word we have is threatened. The meaning of threatened is caused to be vulnerable or at risk. Let's do the meaning of risk. First of all, at risk means something that is facing certain risk that is not safe. So threatened means something that is at risk. Another meaning is caused to be vulnerable. Vulnerable means something that is open to be exploited or to be affected. For example, in this present pandemic of COVID-19, we say that the elderly people are more vulnerable to COVID-19, that is coronavirus, as compared to the youngsters. So it means they are more vulnerable, means there are more chances that they would be affected as compared to the younger ones. So it means that the COVID-19 is threatening elderly people as compared to the younger one. So threatened means that causes something to be vulnerable means open to be exploited or affected, or something that is at risk. I hope that the meaning is clear. Another word we have allied kingdom. Now, my dear student, allied means is the word taken from allies, and allies means friendly countries. The countries or states which are friendly to each other are known as allies. So, allies kingdom is denotes the powerful island nation with many colonies in world. As you can see in the map, the allied kingdom and the Russian Federation will ever be willing to ignore that. That is some another information regarding map. Ignore that. Now, if we talk about allied kingdom, for example, there is Britain. So, Britain and its allies countries, the which are friendly to him, those all countries would be known as allied kingdom. The next word we have empire. Empire means an extensive group of states or countries. Empire basically means a group of countries which are being ruled under a single emperor or king. As you can see in this map, the red highlighted area like Canada, Australia, Indian Empire, Sudan, and there are other names as well. All these countries in 1920, before World War II, were included under British Empire. It means that today's Britain, or you can say that today's England, was ruling all over these countries. These countries were in terms of independent, in terms of their state, that they were separate countries, but their ruler was being ruled by the Britain queen or king. You can say that the Britain country, in today's England, was ruling over all these countries. These all countries were being under the rule of England. So, such group of countries or states is known as empire. And the next word is adversary. Now, adversary means one's opponent in a contest. Opponent means someone who is opposite to you, who is fighting against you, either in terms of a competition or either it is a dispute. So, the person who is against you, fighting against you, would be known as adversary. As you can see, these two are fighting against each other, so both are adversaries to each other. The next word we have defeated, and it means have been beaten in a battle. In a battle, when you lose your war, when you lose the war, that is known as defeat, or you are known as defeated. As you can see in this picture, this is a war battle scene where certain group of enemies would be defeated by the another one. While our next word is tribute. Now, tribute means an act that is intended to show gratitude. For instance, I say that I want to give tribute to Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah. It means I want to show gratitude to Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah. For instance, you thank someone, so you are giving tribute to them as well. And the next word is revenge. Revenge in Urdu is known as badla, and it means to inflict injury in return for. If someone does something to you, and in return, uske badle mein, you inflict injury, or you act in the same manner as a person acted before you, so that thing is known as revenge. And the next word is allies. I told you before, allies means friendly countries. The state formally cooperating with one another. That states or the countries which are friendly to each other are known as allies. And your homework is basically that you have to write these new words and their meaning on loose sheets, and then you have to learn these new words as well. If you have any query, you may ask in the chat box down below.